I mean, what are the chances of, you know, finding a missing person that's been gone for 10 plus years alive? And, you know, it's slim to none almost, but you know, that day we found three.
Officers Michael Tracy, Barbara Johnson, and Anthony Espada had no idea what they were getting into when they got the call to respond to Seymour Avenue on May 6th of last year.
There's a girl on the phone stating that she's Amanda Berry.
Amanda Berry. The name stirs up emotion in any Clevelander who followed her disappearance over a decade ago. Officers Tracy and Espada had that same emotion when they pulled up here to Seymour Avenue on May 6th of last year. They saw a woman standing there with a young girl. Their jaws dropped when it turned out to be Amanda Berry holding her young daughter.
She tells us there's two, Gina and another girl, are still in the house. It's mind-blowing to think that, you know, one high-profile girl right in front of us, missing person, and there's potentially two more in the house. I'll just never forget that feeling.
Cleveland police leaders say you couldn't have picked a better group of three officers to be there that night on Seymour. They're not only excellent officers, but compassionate people. It was a life-changing event for them.
Couldn't sleep that night.
I continue to replay the whole thing.
But as good as it felt that night and in the days after, the change in them was not always so positive.
Just certain images you'll never get out of your head.
And the realization that Amanda Berry, Gina DeJesus, and Michelle Knight could be held captive for so long in a place right there in the neighborhood they patrol every day does make them look at things differently.
I tend to look more curiously at homes now that are darkened, that are the shades pulled down. You just still never know what's going on behind closed doors.
The boarded up houses, it makes you kind of wonder.
Yeah, you don't want to say shady, but you know, I wonder if anybody's in there.
Sure, it may be a dark perspective to have, but having to see what those officers did, it's understandable. However, from that comes something else, hope.
It could be real, gives you hope. I guess not all of them are, you know, you can't think it's going to be a false call.
Hope that another rescue could happen again. Hope that the public is looking out for people who are missing. And hope that neighbors are talking and forming stronger communities to prevent a tragedy like what happened on Seymour Avenue.
We finally did something that you can see good at our job, that people appreciate.
Shout out to Amanda Berry too.
The officers have been able to talk to Michelle, Amanda, and Gina briefly throughout the year. They are glad to see the women are enjoying life. And as the anniversary approaches, they will reflect on what happened that night.
Every day, at least once a day, I'll think about it.
Continue to pray for the three survivors.
You know, they deserve to have a long, fun-filled life.
And continue working towards a positive impact on the people of Cleveland through their tireless work.
Once in a lifetime.
Yeah, absolutely.
Moment.
Never forget.
Career moment right there.
In Cleveland, Todd Meany, Fox 8 News.